Hello everyone, कैसे हैं आप लोग? आज मैं स्वीडिश पार्लियामेंटेरियन वीक में आया हुआ हूँ. इस जगह को आर्मागेडन कहते हैं क्या? व्हाट डू यू कॉल इट? अल्मेडोलन, बट मैं इसको आर्मागेडन कहता हूँ. तो हमारे साथ एक स्वीडिश पार्लियामेंटेरियन है और उनसे हम बात करेंगे. इनका नाम एलिजाबेथ. हाय एलिजाबेथ, हाउ आर यू?
हाय.
आर यू रिलेटेड टू एलिजाबेथ टेलर?
No, but I wish I would.
Okay.
Because then I would be able to sing and dance. And perform like she does.
There you go.
But no.
So but you have your own dance. You have your own music, no?
Oh yes, I have. But you don't want to hear me sing. Then you blow it away. I promise.
What I mean by that is we all have our own little talents and gifts which we come with on this planet to give to other people.
Yeah.
So your gift is helping other people through being a politician.
That is one goal, yeah. But the other goal is to be able to change and be a part of change and to be a part of Sweden moving forward into the future. Because I mean, Sweden has so many capabilities and I want us to be able to use all the capabilities to move Sweden into the future.
So for people who have never been to Sweden, tell me what are the three things they should see when they come here.
Sweden has the most beautiful nature you've ever seen. Sweden has a very beautiful capital city and Sweden has a lot of coast where you can fish. You can enjoy the Swedish, I don't know the English name, but we call it the Allemansrätt, where you can move freely all over. You can pick berries, you can walk, you can use your tent, you can use the land, even though it has an owner. So Sweden is a very open and very welcoming country to everyone. And we want to And be able to show everyone.
Wonderful. Actually, I have only thought of Sweden when I came, before I came, of snow and ice, especially where Bertola lives in the north, and you are also from the north. But I was surprisingly shocked and amazed by the beautiful lakes and the trees. It's just gorgeous. I have no words of how beautiful it is, seriously. Yeah.
And in the summertime, you can have a lot of warm summer nights and especially light. It's light 24/7 and for a lot of people it's very unusual and it's a problem because it's never dark.
Yeah.
But for us who lives here, the light is what we need because we have so many dark hours during winter time, so we need the light.
Yeah.
To create and to absorb energy to be able to handle the winter time.
For those who don't know anything about the political system in Sweden, give us a 2-minute rundown on what the politics is like in this country. Is it like Donald Trump ruling here, or what's going on here? Two-party system?
This political situation in Sweden has never been so confusing as it is right now, because we have a social democrat party ruling in minority with an environmental party, and they have support from the center party and from the liberal party. So a couple of years ago we had an alliance, the conservative party, Christian Democrats, the liberal and the center party, and we had it too. We were in majority and the Social Democrats were in minority. But now it's vice versa and no one really understands what happens in Swedish politics right now. So it's very confusing.
Mm-hmm.
And no one can predict where the decision goes and which legislation will pass the parliament or not, because we don't know how the balance is in the parliament looks like.
What got you into politics? Why did you become a politician from a nurse, right?
You know, I've always had strong opinions, and I always would like wanted to express my opinions, and I'm always into creating change. And I think it's better to be inside and try to create change than rather than being outside, just shouting and achieving nothing. So that's why I get into politics, because I want to be able to change and to be part of, as I said before, bringing Sweden into the future and make Sweden ready to enter the future.
What is your suggestion for the young ones who don't enter into politics and just protest sitting outside the scene? They just comment, they don't do anything about it.
I think civil abundance is a good thing, it is, but I think it's better to, instead of sitting outside the parliament protesting every Friday, I think it's better to enroll in a political party and in that way start a change and start expressing your political thoughts, and in that way starting a change, because I think you need to do it the right way, because otherwise you will be famous, because you will if you refer to Greta.
No, I don't refer to Greta, I refer to everyone. People watching political shows and reading newspaper, they all have an opinion, but they don't do anything about it.
No.
They only have opinions, and they don't do any actions about it, in my opinion.
No, they sit around the table in the kitchen, and they have a lot of ideas and a lot of suggestions how we will change the political situation in Sweden.
But they don't do anything.
It stays there. And I want people to enroll, to get into discussions, to talk to me. And they don't have to enroll in the party, but if they talk to me and give them their suggestions and their thoughts, I would be more than happy to bring them forward, because I mean, that's my job, because I'm elected as a parliamentarian from my region, and I'm a spokesperson for all those people who have elected me. So I really enjoy when people, every Friday when we go shopping for groceries,
people come up to you.
Yeah, my husband gets very tired, because he just walks ahead of me, because it takes hours. Because a lot of people come and say, "Oh, Elisabeth, I've been thinking about this and that. Can we do something about this and that?" And I think that's a very positive thing of politics, because that makes people, they have a lot of good thinking, and that's one of my.
So you are? Can you wear this? Let's see how it looks like. So Elisabeth, I met her only last night, and it's very rare to meet forward-thinking politicians, and she's one of the forward-thinking politicians. Most politicians would never wear these glasses even, and this is, for me, is touching, amazing, gives me hope for the planet, that we have still got politicians who are ready to change themselves, and not just the others, but to themselves. So putting on this kind of bold glasses is giving a signal to the youth that, you know, these are the kind of leadership which you want to engage in. I would like to invite you to start using Facebook Live more, and maybe talk to your constituency people to come in once a week and talk to you, and that is recorded. So that way they know that their voice has been heard, then they will go out and talk about you with everyone. Oh, I was live with Elisabeth and I told her this, and then it's recorded, and they can't confuse it with something else because it's recorded, right? So it'll be wonderful if you do that.
Wearing these glasses, I think that's a sign of me wanting Sweden to be a part of the future, and I wanting to create a change. And I'm not working backwards, because I can't change.
I can
change what happens ahead. So this is bringing Swedish politics forward into the future. That's my mission.
Yeah. Once you become the Prime Minister, what are the three things you would do?
I really look into that it's possible to live in whole Sweden. I will make it possible for us to be more sustainable, because I think that's very, very important. And I would really like to be make it easier to be more entrepreneurs on the market, because we need entrepreneurs to be able to take care of our wealth care program, because I mean we are getting older and no one wants to work inside the healthcare and the wealth. So I think that's my three main questions right now.
Well, I really hope that you would present a bill in the parliament related to entrepreneurship, that the entrepreneurs of the world can come to Sweden. They should be granted a 3-year visa or 2-year something, so like it in the US, like in the UK, and that allows them to stay and work and take advantage and learn the culture of this country.
I think that's very important, because I mean we need entrepreneurs. That's the platform that we have to build Sweden on, because without entrepreneurs we have nothing.
Yeah.
We have no tax income, we have nothing, and we are so dependent on having entrepreneurs in Sweden.
Yeah. Do you know anything about Pakistan?
Not much.
So no. Most people recognize Pakistan by Malala, by Osama bin Laden, who was found there. I want to introduce you a little bit. I want to welcome you there. I would love for you to come and meet our parliamentarians. I'd love to introduce you. Maybe we can have a talk by you at our parliament. And we have the top 7 of the highest peak in the world. But we don't have any ski resorts.
It would be a pleasure of visiting Pakistan. I've been to Bangladesh, I've been to India. But I have one country still to visit.
You're welcome. You have a house there now.
And I have a friend.
Yes. And you will have a lot more friends after this interview, inshallah.
So I will come to Pakistan, I promise.
220 million people, a lot of opportunities for Swedish companies to come there, a lot of opportunities for a lot of carpenters from Pakistan to come here. A lot of co-creation is possible. IKEA doesn't exist in Pakistan yet. We want IKEA to come
to
Pakistan.
Not yet. But
we want tree companies to come to Pakistan. 48% of our country is empty land. We want trees over there. So we want companies over here. We don't want the money. We want the expertise you have built over the hundreds of years of the trees, the green gold, which you call. And those are my dreams. I came with 3 agenda. I came with an agenda to find the IKEA guy and convince him to tell me what do you need to come to Pakistan. Second, I want some cheese companies to come to Pakistan. We don't have cheese makers over there. We have the second largest milk producing country in the world, but we don't make cheese.
But in my region, we have a very big cheese producer, Västerbotten Ost. You know, we have.
I don't know if it's the same one we met, but we met one really good cheesemaker. I think it's the same region. I don't know.
It's a little bit strong cheese, but it's very, very famous.
Okay.
And they make very, very good cheese.
Wonderful. Mm-hmm. And the third was to convince some politicians over here to start their own Facebook show, so that they can empower other people through the power of social media, because you have the people want to hear from our politicians, but they don't come as much as human beings. They come back as like something which we can never be. It's like
unreachable.
But this gives me hope that we have people like you. Thank you so much.
You really convinced me, and I'm so grateful that I met you, and I'm so looking forward to coming to Pakistan and meet you all.
Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone. Please share the video. She's a phenomenal political leader. She has the aspiration to become the next prime minister, the first female prime minister of Sweden. We have had a prime minister who was female, by the way, 2 times.
In Pakistan.
In Pakistan.
Yeah, you're ahead of us. You're ahead of us.
And people in this part of the world think that we are very against women and everything, but we have had prime minister 2 times, which was women, and same as Bangladesh. Bangladesh had 3-time prime minister, which are two different women.
India had,
Bangladesh had, Pakistan had, Sweden did not have.
No, so we are way back of you.
Get her to vote. Get your friends in Sweden to vote for her. let's make her super popular on social media and get her positive thoughts out, and let's make people understand around the world that you, once you have this tool which you're watching us on, you can change the world in your own little way. Thank you so much for watching.
Thank you.